ever since I was introduced to who Kathy Freeman was, that really motivated me and inspired me. And
but you can't play Kathy Freeman in FIFA, the game, like you can play you. So I don't know, I'm calling your achievement higher. Don't tell Kathy. Guys, lovely to meet you.
You too.
As I understand it, you were 8 years old when you went up to mum and dad and said, I'm going to play for Australia. Is that actually true? And were you the most confident eight-year-old that has ever existed?
It is true.
Yeah.
I think I definitely loved my sport as a kid growing up and played rugby league previously. And
you had two sports at the same time for a period,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I played rugby league in under eight. So I was going from my rugby league pitch to my football pitch. One time I had this recollection of it was at the same venue. So they had a soccer pitch and then a rugby league pitch next to each other. And I literally was playing on the same day, a pitch apart from one another.
Away, Freeman out well, a mighty roar.
Basically, I was inspired by the 2000 Olympics, and I think watching Kathy Freeman win gold in front of a home crowd, I realised the enormity of an Olympic Games at that point. I went home and, yeah, just said I want to play for Australia one day to mum and dad, and they were probably thinking, yeah, okay. And then, it happened. I was hard to keep down and I was hyperactive and, yeah, I was a bit of a daredevil when I was a kid and a bit reckless, you could say.
So sport focused that or just, like, enabled it?
I think definitely focused that. Yep. I think to drag my eldest brother out on the trampoline and would play rugby league on the trampoline, he'd be on his knees because he was, by that point, 5-6 foot tall and I was probably 3 foot tall, but
somehow still very deadly on this particular field, I can imagine.
Yeah, so I think I used sport as a force and a drive.
I'm curious how it goes when you hit roadblocks, right? So as I understand it, you had the first major injury when you were 15 years old, and you literally had people telling you she's washed up, she can't do it. Like, firstly, let's take a second to acknowledge that how ridiculous it is they said that to a 15-year-old. Yeah. But, like, so what goes through your head when you're faced with people saying that about you and a potential career?
Yeah, I think at that age, hearing people say that I was washed up and I hadn't even represented our country yet at the age of 15.
I do love that you describe it as yet. It's like, no, it's going to happen. Yeah.
I love proving people wrong in a sense of, if you say that I can't do anything, I'm going to do everything that I physically and mentally can to prove you wrong, to show you that I can.
Mm. Seems like a really healthy way to live. I can't see anything going wrong with that at all.
And fast forward a year down the track from that point on, and I was representing Australia against America, who was the number one team at the time as a 16-year-old. And I still remember the game like it was yesterday. It was torrential rain. It got delayed. There was big puddles. You kicked the ball about 3 metres and stop in a puddle. So rainy, I remember a few of the girls coming up to me and saying, like, you got this, you got this. And yeah, I definitely think that first game when you make your debut for the senior team, you never really forget that moment.
Can I ask about one of your, I guess, more dramatic injuries, which was the time you damaged your ACL? The way I've heard you describe it, horrifying kind of springs to mind.
Yeah, it was a weird one, to be honest. Your ACL is a major injury. It's probably worse than any broken bone that you could have. I'd been nursing a groin issue when I was sitting on the bench, and the coach said to me at the time, are you right to go on? And deep down I didn't really feel 100% right, but I wanted to play. We're playing the US on their home soil, and I think this is the stubbornness coming out in me is you convince yourself that you're right, whether you are or you're not. And the coach said to me, are you right? And I probably told a little white lie, and I said, yeah, I'm right. And I went on and literally, I think 30 seconds had passed, and I changed direction. I felt good when I ran on, and then I changed direction, and the movement felt like it was, you know, the impact of a tidal wave, because it felt like such a great massive movement. And then I was in excruciating pain and couldn't open my eyes, and I was just laying there and my knee was that sore and they had to stretch me off. I watched the replay back maybe a few years later. I couldn't watch it straight away, but I watched the replay back and the movement looked so minute and so tiny that it didn't make sense to me, because it felt like the biggest change of direction I've ever done in my life.
In the years since you started playing football, what do you reckon is the best lesson you've learnt about you, about yourself?
That's a tough one. I think a tough battle when you decide to be an elite sports person is that mental battle you have with yourself of, is this what I really want, or can I find happiness in life elsewhere and in another profession? And more often than not, we're more risky than your everyday Australian. And I think that's why a lot of us have the types of personalities that we do, is because there is a certain point that you need to back yourself and be a little bit selfish. But some people's downfall might be that there's a dissatisfaction or people feel not fulfilled, and that can be elite sports people's downfall sometimes.
So recently you were injured with your shoulder, and actually as part of the recovery process you moved in with your mum, your younger brother, and one of the things that came out of that process, I understand, is you learnt a lot more about your family history, a lot of stuff that I guess had gone quite unsaid in your family. And one of those things that came out was the story of your nan. She was taken away as an Aboriginal woman. She was taken away from her family when she was young, wasn't she?
Yeah, she was. A half-caste, so they call. Taken away at a young age and then found my Poppy Reg. I don't think his family was very accepting of Nan's Aboriginal backgrounds. They had to work for his family, for her to be allowed to be in the house, and to moving with her 13 kids down to Sydney. At one point having to live in her sister's room and had nothing but a gas stovetop, probably the size of a soccer ball actually, and that's the only thing that they could cook on. And when you meet her today even, she's still that strong, empowering woman, and you can tell what she's been through just with how strong she is and how powerful she is to be around.
Why do you think they decided to not tell you some of the details until quite recently?
Well, always away, and the only time I really have at home is when I've got an injury. So, you know, it's a
all right, now we need to catch you up on some things.
It's a blessing in disguise, to be honest. Every time I suffer an injury, I get closer and closer to my family, and I get to spend more time with my family. So that's
maybe they're sabotaging you. Have you considered that?
So. My brother two-foots me in the lounge room. It's like that.
Behind for barely a minute, Kyah Simon has rescued it for Australia.
In from Kyah Simon.
The bottom line is I wanted to, you know, make my family proud for all of what they've sacrificed for me to be able to be in the position that I'm in today. I can go away and travel the world and play football abroad and in World Cups and Olympics, but whenever I come home, if there's one thing that sticks out, it's probably the power of resilience. You won't survive, or you can't survive, if you don't have that mental toughness. And I think that's because there's so many peaks and troughs in sports people's lives and careers. And it's never smooth sailing.
If it was smooth sailing, do you think you'd like it as much?
Probably not. I think
you'd appreciate it as much?
I think definitely not appreciate it. And I think that one of the main points of every time I've had a major injury or a major setback is my appreciation grows more and more for what I do and what I can do, and for the small things to get you through those tough times.
Okay, thanks so much for your time.
It's great. Thank you.